Yes, friends, as the incredibly hyperbolic title of this video implies, you can indeed organize your iPhone home screen in such a way that it will transform you into an ultra-powerful work robot with superpowers of productivity. If that weren't the case, why would I and so many other supposedly productive people on the internet spend so much time organizing their iPhone home screens? It just wouldn't make sense. So, let's begin. Before we jump into my current setup, I think it'd be good to contrast it with the previous one. So here's a shot of my old home screen. Not terrible, but not really great either. Aside from the game sitting in the home screen that shouldn't be there, there's a lot of visual clutter. Alright, let's move on. The main thing you'll notice about my current iPhone setup is that it consists of only one screen. I've chosen not to fill the whole screen up with apps. Instead, I've realized that leaving some space looks a lot nicer. Instead of trying to fill every single slot with an app, I've narrowed my choices down to the 16 apps that I use most or that are most useful to me. The rest of the apps live in one of four folders: Work, Play, Go, and Sift. Choosing these four categories took a lot of thought. My conclusion after thinking about it for a while is that besides the many apps I have related to transportation or travel, most perform actions that either help me get things done or help me have fun. The ones that don't fit live in the Sift folder, which I thought was a better word than junk or other. My home screen app choices are also set up to maximize my efficiency and keep me from playing with my phone more than I need to. On the productivity side, I have apps like Todoist, Google Calendar, and Pomodoro. By the way, the specific Pomodoro app I use is called Pomodoro Timer, though there are a lot of other ones to choose from. The second ideal, reducing phone time, is why you don't see Safari on the home screen. I'm trying to get in the habit of writing down ideas of things I want to look up so I can do more concentrated research later rather than interrupting whatever it is I'm doing right now. That's why an app called Drafts lives in my dock. It allows me to open it and immediately start writing. After that, I can easily export my note to Evernote and process it later. I also don't keep Facebook or other social media apps on my home screen. I found that keeping them in the folders actually discourages me from using them too much. Tweetbot and Instagram are the only ones that get a place on my home screen, as I post on them regularly, but I don't really find myself scrolling through them very often. A couple of other things I've done to reduce distractions. For one, no apps are allowed to have badge notifications except for the text message and phone apps. I've also massively cut down on actual notifications my phone will send me, and lastly, my phone goes into do not disturb mode from 11 PM to 6 AM, so absolutely nothing will get a hold of me unless it's somebody calling for the second time. Alright, so maybe you watch this video and you're thinking to yourself, wait a minute, that guy made a speed reading video last week and he promised me another speed reading video this week, so where's the speed reading video? Explanation. So this being Wednesday as I record this, tomorrow morning I'm hopping on a plane to go down to Charlotte, North Carolina for a conference called FinCon, and unlike most of the conferences I go to, at this one I happen to be speaking. Given that, most this week has been dedicated to designing that presentation, creating my slides, practicing it because unfortunately, unlike YouTube, I can't just do takes over and over again until I get it right, and hence there wasn't enough time left over to make that follow-up video at a level of quality that you guys deserve. So hopefully you enjoyed this shorter video. I'll have the next video in the speed reading series out next Thursday when I'm back from North Carolina. I'm gonna get back to practicing my speech before my plane takes off. And yes, before you ask, there will be a video coming soon on how to make better presentations, so look forward to that. And in the meantime, if you got tips of your own on setting up your smartphone in a more productive way, or you have app recommendations, leave them down in the comments below, and I will see you in the next video. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching this video. If you want to get new videos every single week on being a more effective student, click the big red subscribe button right there. You can get a free copy of my book on earning better grades by clicking the picture of it, and also if you'd like to see the companion blog post for this video with a summary and links to any of the apps and resources I mentioned, you can click the orange logo right there. Last week, as I mentioned, was the first video in my series on speed reading, so if you didn't happen to see it, click the thumbnail to watch it, and also if you'd like to connect with me, I'm on Twitter @TomFrankly, or you can leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching!